me because there's somebody has deemed it that we're going to lay a concrete slab the whole way down there. Now, from our point of view, with budgets and money being short, I don't want to have to pay to have that all gunned down. And I don't want to then have to get rid of it all. So the idea being is that could be rear access. What I want to do is rip the distance each side of another border, initially just a straight border to be cut.
Yeah.
Over time, as the project continues, what we're going to do is we're going to put in some shapes and we're going to somewhat change things, just because from a design perspective, it's quite boring. Just two straight lines is going to be very boring, whereas if you start introducing heights and different, you start to see through things. So your viewpoint changes, and that means that the residents can't see a flat garden in front of them. It's more three-dimensional. So, you know, there's things in the way. There's different colours, different heights. And if we're careful with the planting, we can use things that you see through. They don't block your view. You can see through them, but you're still getting a sense of interest. So without even touching on the planting and the plants, what I propose we do is take a measurement from fence to edge of path there, and then we come from, what we'll be doing is we'll be working from this edge here to wherever we say. And then it's simply down to the top, which is far too easy. At that point you're getting bored.
It's finish training as well.
Exactly.
I'm just saying how easy it is to cut turf at this rate.
It is very, it is. If you know what you're doing and you get a little bit of the technique, I'm sure that the friend will help us all out. So then we're going to cut and then we have to bag. And I have bought quite a few bags.
We literally just cutting the turf and everything out.
We're just going to take the turf off initially. Once you've got that shape and you've got a decent line, that's when you then start to pocket forking or a post spade. I mean, I've been using post spades in a very different way to what they were designed for years, because I'm tiny. If I need to transplant that tree, I've got no upper body strength, and it's just not going to happen. What I discovered 20 years ago is if you develop a way of using post spade, which you all know is steel, you can move mountains.